Good morning, Commissioner. Or good afternoon, I guess, at this point.
Yeah, what time is it?
Who knows? You know, hearing room B is one, you know, there's, you never know what, you come in the morning and you leave when it's dark. But I do want to thank you for your answers. I only have a few minutes, so I'll kind of jump right into it. But back in 2013, you may recall there was $40 million in funds set aside for a competition in Niagara Falls, of which one of the awardees or one of the projects that came out of that was the Wonder Falls, the $150 million project. This was going to be a hotel, indoor water park, restaurants, and other entertainment and retail space in what used to be the Rainbow Center Mall, downtown Niagara Falls there. There were several press conferences, including one with the governor, where they came, where they announced 1,500 indirect jobs would be created, including 300 permanent jobs. Can you tell me today, have any of those jobs materialized?
Well, you know, we've gotten a lot done. Let me start by saying we've gotten an enormous amount done in Niagara Falls. I think an unprecedented amount of progress in Niagara Falls in recent years. I think you'd agree with that. I think anyone would. That project is it hasn't happened, but it will. That's my most sincere belief. And we are, we've been negotiating that agreement. It's a complex project. I think you know there are not that many $100+ million projects in the city of Niagara Falls. The site that you refer to is particularly complicated. There has been great progress in Niagara Falls, which is encouraging for all of us, including the developers of that project. We are in very active negotiation to finalizing those negotiations. I think you'll see good progress on that project. There's no guarantee, but it's taken longer than we would have liked. That does happen. But in the meantime, we've done an enormous amount of investment and progress, and seen enormous amount of progress in tourism, tourism assets, infrastructure, connecting that city back to its waterfront, park infrastructure, you name it. Niagara Falls has come a long way. That project is still very much a priority, and I think you'll see very positive developments on that project soon.
Okay, and that's good to hear, even if it is 5 years on. And the reason I ask, though, is beyond the fact for this hearing alone, as you probably are also aware, there have been other, as you alluded to, projects in Western New York, specifically in Niagara Falls, where there have been hotels or retail tourism-like projects that are announced and then either don't materialize, and I'm talking over long years of history, or like the Hamster project, are scaled back so much that they don't even reflect what was initially outlined. With this project, obviously there was a lot made about that. The mayor made a lot about it. A lot of local officials did. Has there been any money at this point committed to that project? I mean,
which project are you?
The Wonder Falls project.
The Wonder Falls project, we've identified some funds for that, and we're in final negotiations with the developer. So we haven't, you know, committed anything that they haven't committed to. So our commitment is only contingent on them doing the project, obviously. So we're getting close. You know, Hotel Niagara was a project that we, you know, inherited and have moved the ball forward on in a significant way. I think you're familiar with that. Mm-hmm. There's been, I think, 8 new construction or rehabilitated hotel projects in Niagara Falls. I don't think there's anywhere in upstate New York, truthfully, where there's been more hotel investment in recent years than Niagara Falls. Now, you know, I get it. We can point to something and say this is taking too long. I agree. But in fairness, just in fairness, I think we should put that in the context of an enormous amount of hotel investment that in fact has occurred in Niagara Falls. Infrastructure investment, private sector investment, and growth in tourism and the economy.
Well, there's certainly been a lot of subsidization of hotels, which is welcome. If we can just keep the people there now, for other reasons. I've never traveled anywhere to stay in a nice hotel. I've always traveled to do something, and then I need a hotel as well. So, you know, if we can make that next step, I think that'll be very important. Just jumping into my next, the film tax credit, which I'm sure you're familiar with, seeing as it's $420 million. Anything with economic development, I'm sure you'd agree, centers around ROI, right? Return on investment. You're spending a lot of money or spending dollars, and at some point you have to look back and say, okay, is this working? Is this not working? And I think there's nothing wrong with doing that and then sticking with programs that work, that create long-term jobs, and obviously maybe abandoning or changing programs that are not working. Can you tell me, or is there any data that you have or could provide that shows what the film and television industry spent in New York, or you know, the amount of films that were filmed here prior to the enactment of the tax credit versus since the tax credit has been enacted?
It's dramatic. But you should know, I mean, you're talking about that industry has now grown like 300 to 400% in the last less than 10 years, 300%, I think. It's enormous. The spending has, the employment has, it's hitting record after record. It's that industry is employing hundreds of thousands of people. The industry is investing many billions of dollars annually, and it is a booming industry. And you know, if you ever watch Netflix or go to the movies or any of those things, that industry is growing, and it's growing in New York. And you know, if it's a very interesting statistic to look and see how pre and post film tax credit, depending on how far you want to go, that industry has grown dramatically. And it's a very competitive industry. We're not the only ones who have a film tax credit. Mm-hmm. Georgia, Louisiana, Connecticut, Canada, Toronto. It's a competitive industry, but when we change the film tax credit, boy, if you look at that and you know draw that old chart over time and the incentive, it's a hockey stick in the right direction. It's all up and to the right. So it's we do share your concern about return on investment. We do studies with Des Moines. The return is positive, 15%. But that industry has grown tremendously, for sure. And I do, you know, there's been more productions upstate than there ever have been. So, you know, while it's New York City downstate centric, it has benefited upstate as well. There's been more productions in Western New York this past year than I think there ever have been or have been in a very long time. Post-production is growing as well, dramatically. So I think that industry is doing very well in terms of employment and growth and investment in New York.
And as you said, most of it is centered downstate, I mean, to be fair. I guess my concern has always been New York and California have always been hubs for the film industry. I guess I'm just curious as to why that industry was selected for, I think, the largest industry-specific credit versus, let's say, manufacturing or agriculture, right, or some other type of industry, especially when I think it's fair to say that most of the jobs, not all of them, but most of them are short-term,
right,
employment jobs.
You know, it's a highly mobile industry. It's a competitive industry. That's, one of the things that we're starting to see with the advent of Netflix and things like that. People are making longer commitments and keeping people employed longer, and they're not. So that, I think, is a positive development in the industry.
Thank you, Commissioner. I'm out of time, and I appreciate your answers.